Hello friends, welcome to Alpha Point. This is Vishal. In this video, I will be showing you Ditto Note 4 ROM for Samsung Galaxy Note 2 with almost all the features of Note 4. Let's first check the Android version and the ROM details. Here we can see the Android version, baseband version, kernel version. You can also see the model number of this device has been changed to the model number of Note 4. Let's start with the home screen. The home screen looks exactly like the Note 4 with its wallpaper in the background. The new weather widget, the icons looks exactly same as of Note 4 as the applications has been ported from Note 4. When you will use it for the first time, you will notice that the buttons also work as of Note 4. Now the option button will also show recent applications and long pressing it will make you edit your home screen preferences, change wallpapers, add or remove widgets, add new home screen and other miscellaneous home screen settings. The functions of Task Manager has also been minimized. Now move on to the lock screen. This is how the lock screen looks like in this DN4 ROM. The default time, date, weather information, carrier information at the bottom center and the camera widgets at the bottom right corner. You can have up to 14 unlocking transition effects. You can also make lock screen to show charging effects when you put your device on charge. Now, let's move to the status bar. This is how our status bar looks like with various settings shortcut. The screen brightness shortcut, S Finder, Quick Connect, just enlarge the status bar widget by pressing here. Not much change, but there is an addition of download booster which combine your Wi-Fi and mobile data to improve internet speed. The side panel keys which creates a virtual button on your screen with their respective functions. You can edit it and can have maximum of 4 buttons at a given time. You can also edit its transparency. The next is ultra power saving mode. You may have seen this option in Samsung Galaxy S5 and previous DN3 ROMs. This makes your device black and white, stretching background processes and let you open just few essential applications to save battery life. Now look at the app drawer. These are the default applications in this ROM ported from Note 4. The new phone, contacts, messages, internet application and other essential applications can be seen here. This is how the applications looks like. I really like the new gallery application in which we can make the thumbnail to much more smaller. Camera is same as of Note 2. The new music player, video player, clock, calendar, new S Note which I will show later and other applications. There is an addition of pen up where you can share your artwork with other Note users. And also there is an addition of Agni Control. Since this ROM has Agni kernel, so using Agni Control you can tweak your device to extreme levels. You can tweak your various hardware and software features, but be careful while using it as it may break your device due to improper usage. Now move to the just Note 4 features. Air command. The air command has been completely changed from its previous version. Now it has just 4 options here. There are little bugs in action memo and also in the smart select. Action memo works same as it was in previous version, but due to bug it sometimes doesn't recognize when you try to link the written text to any functions. There is also a bug in smart select. It doesn't let you select the screen unless you are very fast. Image clip let you select the required portion on the screen and then you can save it to the scrapbook or share it via various applications. The last air command function, screen write, will let you capture the whole screen and let you write anything on it. Then save it or share it to your friends. Now look at the new multi-window and pop-up window. Keep pressing the back button will show the multi-window bar and we need to just tap on any application. If that application is optimized to open in pop-up window, then it will open. Here, we can have a maximum of 5 applications open at a time. In pop-up window, we can minimize the application or copy the text inside it and paste it directly in any other application we can maximize the application to. We can also make any application in pop-up window by dragging our finger from either side of upper corners. New multi-window can also be opened from recent applications. Open recent application. Tap on multi-window option here, then select the next application to open it in multi-window. You can add more application in multi-window mode using multi-window manager application. The new S Note. The interface in the new S Note has changed slightly. The new feature includes Fot Note, in which you can take note from any screen or any book or any page and edit it inside the S Note. I really like this feature. In new S Note, you can also insert various options like voice memo, image, videos, scrapbooks, maps, etc. Now the settings option. Here we can have the list view and tab view option, and you can edit the quick settings from here. Here we can see all the connection settings. I don't think I have to go through every settings, as you may be familiar with these settings. These are the device settings. There is a new addition of festival effect, which shows graphical effect in your status bar, lock screen, in any festival occasion or on birthday events. Floating messages open a pop-up window instantly when you are watching videos or games. You can reply through it instantly. Your personalization settings, your system settings, and lastly your application settings. Final verdict on this ROM is that the ROM is stable but needs a little bit improvement in Air Command functions and Google settings. Many bugs has been fixed with regular updates, but many are still there. This is a great ROM and hope it will improve in future. If you have any suggestion, do comment, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. This is Vishal signing out.